Hello students, how are you? Now in the last lecture I have discussed about conduction. Okay, so in this lecture I will discuss about the process of flow of energy, which is convection. Conduction was a process of flow of energy in solids, but in convection is a process of flow of energy in fluids. Means liquid or gases, both are called fluids. Okay, so what is convection? At first I am writing the definition. Convection is the process of flow of energy in which the molecules of the medium move from hotter region to cooler region carrying heat with it and cooler molecules move to the source means source of heat. So see this. Convection is a process of flow of energy in which the molecules of the medium move from hotter region to the cooler region carrying heat with it, and cooler molecules move to the source of the heat. This point, molecules of the medium move. What did you see in solids? For solids, the molecules are fixed. They vibrate at its own position and collide with the neighboring molecule, and the energy is given by the molecule due to collision. But here the molecules are moving. Molecules of the medium are moving. Medium means fluid. That may be liquid or that may be gas. That means here the molecules carrying heat with it. Molecules with the heat move from one point to another point. That means hotter region to cooler region, and the heat is flows by the molecules to the hotter region to the cooler region. Understand? So here molecules move, but for solid molecule does not move. So this is the difference between conduction and convection. For convection, molecules of the medium or the fluid move carrying heat with it, and the cooler molecule move to the source of the heat, and the cooler molecule again heated and then move to the cooler region, and again cooler molecule. I'm explaining this. So understand this. To understand this, how does convection occur? Now you know, for liquid or gas the molecules are free to move. For fluid, molecules are free to move. They can move easily. Okay, they can move easily. That's why it expands. So as the molecules of the fluid are free to move, then if the fluid is heated then it starts to expand and becomes less dense. So as it becomes less dense, then it will start to rise upward, and in the upward there has cool dense molecule, and which start to move to the downward. to the source of the heat, and then the cooler molecule start to heat. Understand? Suppose there has heat here. Heat is given by the candle. Okay, there is the molecules. Okay, oh, here also has the molecules. When the molecules is heated, then it start to expand. If it is it start to expand, then what will happen? It become less dense. Okay, so when it is heated, that means when it is heated, then it become less dense, then it start to rise upward, because then it is very light, halka ho jata hai. And the molecules in the upside, in the upper region, it is cooler molecule, which if it is heated or the molecules or hot molecules is less dense and start to rise in the upward, and the molecules in the upper region is more dense and cooler, then it start to flow to the downward direction to the source of the heat, and the molecule comes to that region, and again this molecule start to be heated. If it is heated, then it also become less dense, then it start to rise again from upper region, cooler dense molecule sinks down to the source of the heat, again the molecules are heated. This process or this cycle continues. This cycle continues. Molecules heated will become less dense, start to rise, cooler molecules dense sinks down to the source, again the molecules be heated, rise, cooler molecules sinks down. This process continues and heat flows in this way. This process is called convection. Understand? This process is called convection, and by this process the whole fluid or whole water or gas, liquid or gas, become heated, equally heated. Okay, that means heat is transferred from one from hotter region to cooler region by the molecules. That is, molecules carry the heat. Molecule carry the heat itself and rise, and this process, heat is transferred to the whole region. Okay, this process is called convection. Understand? Understand? In convection, molecules carry the heat itself and start to move. Again also cooler molecules start to move to the source, and it is heated. Then in this way this process continues, and in this way the whole molecule become equally heated, or it is transferred to the whole molecules or whole region. This process is called convection. Okay, okay. Applications of convections. Applications of convection. What are the application? First application, there are natural application. You know that, you know, in coastal area, in coastal area during the day there is a gentle breeze from sea to the land, and in night, during night, there is a gentle breeze from land to sea. Okay, this is due to the convection current. This is due to the convection current. How I'm explaining this? Before this explaining, you remember land is heated or become cool faster than sea. Remember, land is heated faster than land is heated or cooled faster than sea. Okay, remember this. Land heated or cooled faster than sea or sea water. Okay, now what happened during day? During day the land become heated
the land is heated due to the sun at higher temperature than the sea. Understand? During the day, the land is heated during due to the sun at higher temperature than sea. Okay. Suppose there is a land. This is the land. And there is sea. This sea. In the day, what happened? There is sun. Land is heated more than sea at higher temperature. Then the air above the land become hotter and become less dense and start to rise. Okay, so as it the land is heated, so air above the land become less dense and become hotter and start to rise upward. Okay, and the now the cooler air from the sea will try to fill this area and start to move in this way. Okay, so that's why we get a gentle breeze from sea to land during day. Understand how? Okay, to fill this, the air, cooler air from sea start to blow from sea to land. This is called sea breeze. So what is sea breeze? During day, as the land is in coastal area, during day land is heated more than the sea, then the air above the land become heated and become less dense and start to rise upward. And to fill this area, the air, cooler air from the sea start to move from sea to the land. Then we get a breeze which is called sea breeze. Understand? Okay. And what did I say? Land is become hotter or heated faster than sea. Also cool faster than sea. So during night land is become cool. Okay, so the air above the sea is warmer, that is more hot than the air above the land. Okay, so this warm air start to rise, and this if it rises, then to fill this area, air from the land start to move from land to sea. Okay, understand? So this is called land breeze. Understand what is land breeze? Land breeze is nothing but the reverse of sea breeze. At the night, land is become cool than sea. So the air above the sea is warmer than the air above the land. Then the warm air above the sea start to rise upward. And to feel this, the air from the land start to move to the sea. And this is called the land breeze. The breeze which is move from land to sea during night at coastal area is called land breeze. So understand what is land breeze and what is sea breeze. Okay, that way this is the first one. Second, you know car engine. So car engines are cooled by convection currents set in water pipes around the combustion chamber. Okay, so as the combustion chamber is heated, so this is the combustion chamber and there has a air pipe filled with, suppose this is the pipe, this is a pipe filled with water. So the heat from, if the water is moving, then heat flows to the water and the cool and hot water start to flow. And to fill this hot water, to fill this place, cool water again pass through it. So the car engines become cooled. So car engines are cooled by convection current set in water pipes around the combustion chamber. Okay, this is the combustion chamber, suppose. Okay, this is our second and third is, you know, in many factories there is long chimneys, and through the chimneys hot air pass through it. Okay, smoke and hot air or gases pass through it due to convection current, because there are very less dense and start to rise in upward direction. So these are the applications of convection or convection currents. I hope you all understand. Thank you.